I'd like to explain modeling in this slide. In control engineering, plant model is important to design controller. So the plant model is given as a mathematical dynamical model. Mathematical model is such as transfer function and state equation. The model is derived using the physical modeling and using the input-output relation of the plant system. And this is known as a system identification. I'd like to introduce transfer function in this slide. Transfer function plays an important role in control engineering and control theory. The form is given by this equation. G is a transfer function. The denominator and numerator is given as a polynomial of S. In case N equals to M, this is known as biproper system, and M is larger than M, then the transfer function is a strictly proper system. I explain state equation in this slide. State equation takes important role in control engineering. This is the form of the state equation. T means time, X is state, U and Y are control input and control output, and N is the order of the system. Equation is given as the time derivation of x and a times x plus b times u. I introduce stability in this slide. In control engineering, stability is one of the most important topics. So in state equation, real part of all eigenvalues of a are negative, then the system is asymptotically stable. And in case of transfer function, real part of root of the denominator polynomial are negative, then the system is asymptotically stable. The matter function are given like this. I'd like to introduce discretization of the continuous system. In the continuous time system, the state equation is given by this form. But in case of discrete time system, state equation is given like this. And transfer function is given like this, and the transfer function of the case of discrete time system is given like this. The keyword to discretization is bilinear transform in case of transfer function. I explain stability of the discrete time system in this slide. Discrete time system is given like this form in case of state equation, and transfer function is given like this. In discrete time system, when the all poles are in unit cycle, then the control system is asymptotically stable. The poles are the eigenvalue of A and the root of the polynomial of this equation. And in another approach, Jury stability criterion is known as to consider the stability of the discrete time system. The Lyapunov equation for discrete time system is given like this. And when this equation can be achieved, the system is asymptotically stable. I'd like to introduce linearization of nonlinear system part 1. In case of a linear system, many control design methods exist. On the other hand, in case of nonlinear system, it is difficult to analyze. So in many cases, the control system of nonlinear system is linearized as a linear system. And one method is approximation using Taylor expansion. By Taylor expansion, we can consider this factor as a A matrix and this factor as a B matrix. I'd like to introduce linearization of nonlinear system part 2. In case of a linear system, many control design methods exist. On the other hand, in case of nonlinear system, it is known as difficult to analyze. So the nonlinear system is reduced to a linear system in many cases. We introduce feedback linearization in this figure. At the first, I introduce the case of first order system. In this case, when feedback input is given like this, then the linear system can be obtained. In case of high order system, it is known as feedback linearization and output zeroing methods. I would like to introduce H2 norm in this slide. H2 norm is defined by this equation, and by using Parseval's theorem, L2 norm of the impulse response of G is equal to the H2 norm. The Mathurin function is given like this. I would like to introduce H infinity norm in this slide. This norm plays an important role in robust control analysis and synthesis. The norm can be given as a maximum amplitude for all frequency in the Bode diagram. I'd like to introduce internal model control in this slide. The controller form is given like this, and P is a plant and PM is the model of the plant. C is a controller. In this form, it is effective for control system with delay. If the plant has delay and PM has also delay, so the effect of delay can be disappeared by this feedback loop. I would like to introduce disturbance observer in this slide. Disturbance observer is given like this form. P is the plant and PM is the inverse of the plant model. And by using this form, the compensated system is given like this, and the input-output relation can be similarized to PM. So the robustness of the control system is increased by using disturbance observer. I would like to introduce model error compensator in this slide. The form of model error compensator is given like this. P is plant and PR is the plant model. And by using this filter, the input-output relation can be similarized to the plant model. So by using this compensator, the robustness is higher in this case. In many cases, D is given as a high gain filter. Anti-wind-up compensator is introduced in this slide. We consider control system with saturation. Saturation function is written by this form. Input limit is considered in this control system. When the control input is in the limit, the control system works fine. But in case of the signal is out of the limit, the wind-up is occurred. So to consider the saturation effect, we consider an anti-wind-up form in the control system. I'd like to introduce three types of finite time setting control. At the first part, discrete time system is shown in this slide. State equation is given like this, and in case of asymptotically stable, all poles are in unit cycle is the condition for this stability. On the other hand, all poles of the control system A are zero. In this case, all of the states goes to zero within the finite time. I'd like to introduce finite time settling control in this slide. This slide shows a case of continuous time systems. For the continuous time system, the finite time settling control can be achieved using finite Laplace transform. At the first step, GS includes delay component like this, and appropriate setting of the parameters, then the finite time control can be achieved. This slide shows the finite time settling control for the case of nonlinear system. The example is given like this. When this equation is satisfied, the state goes to zero at finite time T0. It is possible to extend the nonlinear finite time settling control to high order system.